Okay, so let's look at this arithmetic sequence and let's determine if we can find the rule. Okay, so a couple of things we need to identify firstly is by seeing what happens when we go from term 1 to term 2 to term 3. Well, we can see there's an addition of 10, an addition of 10, and an addition of 10. And this will continue up until infinity, right? So the first formula we need to know is a sub n is equal to a sub 1 plus n minus 1 d. So this d is known as the common difference. It's a common difference, okay? And what a common difference is that when we see the same value getting added or subtracted from a sequence, well, we can determine that would then be the common difference. So let's write it over here. D would be equal to 10. Well, what about this A1? Well, this A1 would be considered the first term. So the first term of the sequence. So we can look at the sequence by where did the sequence start? Well, the sequence started by 10. So that would be A1. Now we can continue this pattern by looking at the second term, that would be A2, A3, A4, and so forth. So let's try to find the rule. Well, now that I know what A1 is, I can substitute 10. I know that the n for now we're just going to leave. We want to find n. We want to actually calculate, or we want to create a rule to calculate n. And then I can add my common difference. So the two things that we need is we need A1 and we need D. If we have these two factors or from the equation, we can pretty much solve AN, A sub N. So I can say 10, I'm going to distribute this 10 into the parentheses by 10 multiply N and 10 multiplying negative 1. So that's going to give me 10N minus 10. These two simply cancel each other out. 10 minus 10 is 0. Therefore, a sub n is equal to 10n. Now let's test if this rule's true. Well, I want to find the fourth term. Okay, we know the fourth term is supposed to be 40. But let's see. So I want to find a sub 4. I can find a sub 4 by substituting 4 into n. So n would then just refer to the term. Okay. So I want the fourth term. And then 10 multiplied 4 gives me 40. And in fact, my fourth term is 40.